Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello.
Hi, teacher.
How are you?
Hi, good evening.
Good evening, everyone. How was your day? It's good. It's almost Friday.
Tomorrow is Friday.
Almost. So it's almost Friday.
Yeah.
Kathy, it's almost Friday. And did you get paid today?
Friday, yes. Little.
I'm sorry, Domingo. Can you repeat, please?
Friday, little.
Oh, okay. Did you get paid today, people?
Yeah. October 8th.
Oh, until October the 8th.
Good evening.
Hi, fine. Me too. Good evening, Jasmine.
And the next in October 22.
October 22nd.
22nd, yeah.
Okay, good. Very good. Okay, guys. So it's our video conference number 11. Welcome to your class. To your class video conference number 11. And today I'm so excited because we're going to start a very interesting and topic for you, which is the simple past. Have you studied the simple past before?
Can you repeat, teacher?
Have you studied the simple past before?
No, teacher.
No? Okay.
No.
So I will have the privilege and the honor of teaching you the simple past. I hope to do it well.
Okay.
Okay, so class 11. What is the topic of class 11, Nancy? Nancy.
Here.
Oh,
hello, hello.
What is the topic of class 11?
Que la lea, teacher.
Please.
How to pass on being the simplest. Pass affirmative.
Okay, I'm gonna read it for you. And you repeat, Nancy, okay? Listen, listen, and then you say it. Class number 11, how to use past of be and simple past affirmative.
How to do past of be and simple past affirmative.
Excellent. Class objective. Participants will be able to write three sentences using the past of be and the simple past in affirmative way correctly individually.
Class objective.
Participants.
To write three sentences using the past of be I the simple past in the affirmative way correctly individual.
Thank you, Nancy. Yes, you did it pretty well. Okay, so that is the class for today. Right now I'm going to take the attendance, okay? So please listen over here. Alba Vides? Alfredo Alexander.
Present, teacher.
Amir Carcañengues. Carlos Gualberto.
Present.
Cristina Romero.
Present.
Domingo González.
Present, teacher.
Fátima Portillo. José Matías Lemus.
I'm here. Present.
Okay, thank you. Marco Velázquez.
Present, teacher.
Marlon Cardona.
Present.
Mauricio Majano. Maideli Judith. Nancy Lizeth Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Rocío Martínez. Salvador Escobar. Sandra Velázquez. Víctor Salazar. Walter Daniel González. William Eduardo Pérez. Yasmín Melanie Lemos. Okay. Thank you guys for being here. Oh, okay, Maideli and Walter are oyentes. Maideli and Walter. Okay. Thank you guys. Okay, so let's continue with our class. So, which activities do we have for today's class? Let's see. Domingo, I see you are falling asleep. Please, can you read the agenda?
Okay. We're up. Pressing on packs. Activity one, vocabulary and sentences. Activity two, pass us be, was and were. Activity three, pass simple us other verb. Activity four, role play, wrap up.
Wrap up. Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Alex Gonzalez. Okay, so in the warm up, we are going to practice the verbs in the past tense of these verbs, okay? Then, guys, we are going to learn some vocabulary related to customer service. And we are going to learn about the past of the was and where, and then the past simple of other verbs. So let's begin. For the activity of the verbs, we are going to try to go to this website, okay? So just let me go to the website. Okay, give me one moment because I forgot to do it before. And we are going to play this game. Do you know the verbs in past? Which verbs, what do you know about the simple past of verbs? What do you know?
Los que mandó el WhatsApp, teacher.
Sorry?
Los verbos que mandó el WhatsApp, no.
Yeah, that was an exercise that I sent for you to practice. Pero ¿qué saben? What do you know about the simple past of verbs?
Well, for example, there are regulars and irregular verbs.
Exactly.
You cannot be D, E, D, or you can change the base form of the verb.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes, in the past, there are two types of verb. We have regular verbs, and we have irregular verbs. And today, you're going to study both regular and irregular verbs, and we are going to study the difference. Also, you remember that the verb be is a special. So the past of be is different as the past of the other verbs, okay? So right now, you are going to see this and we are gonna do it together, this exercise. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, so you have to match the irregular verbs correctly. For example, what is the past of am and is? What is the past of are, do, go, eat, have, make, take, see, fly, sell, tell, and send. Okay, and we have the past in this column. Did, was, where, had, went, saw, flew, sold, told, found, make, took, eight and sent. So the characteristic of irregular verbs is that the majority of irregular verbs change completely, and you have to learn, you have to memorize which are the irregular verbs. Okay, for example, the past of am and is
Was,
exactly.
Was.
The past of are.
Were.
The past of do.
Did.
Go.
Went.
Eat.
Ate.
Okay. Eight. The past of have.
Had.
The past of make.
Made.
The past of take.
Took.
The past of see.
So.
The past of fly.
Flew.
The pronunciation is flew. The past of sell.
Sold.
The past of tell.
Told.
The past of find.
Found.
Yes, the past of send.
Sent,
exactly. Very good, nice.
Teacher.
Yes, Mr. Cañengas.
Can you share in WhatsApp this list, the verbs, please?
Okay.
Puede compartirlos. Porque así en pantalla no salen todos. Sale cortado.
Okay, I send the links of this exercise is in the presentation.
Okay.
But anyway,
pero ahí cuesta sacar solo una página, tica. Tiene que ser porque yo lo imprimo, ¿verdad? Entonces Este, lo que dice Cañengue no sale completo.
Ajá, sale cortado, entonces si usted lo compartiera o hiciera algo, no sé, no me ayuda.
Yes, I'm gonna send it to you, don't worry.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Ustedes mandan.
Ah, solo que nadie nos obedece, ¿verdad?
Ah. ¿Cómo no?
Nosotros
miren.
Mandamos, pero nadie nos obedece.
Claro, miren, yo aquí ahorita les estoy haciendo caso.
Eso, Bárbara.
Solo que my internet is very slow when I'm using Zoom. Okay, en lo que carga, we continue.
Yes. Yes.
You're gonna see all my messages. Okay. Let's see. One, two, three, nothing. Okay. The semi-regular verbs, the only difference they have from present to past is one vowel. You just have to change one vowel. For example, swim, the past of swim is?
Swam.
Swam, exactly. Solo cambia la vocal, ¿verdad? La I por la A. Ya es pasado. Swim, swam. Get?
Eso es regular verb.
Eat. Irregular
verb.
Irregular.
We have get, got. Solo que got está aquí, miren bien.
Bien abajo. Got, sí. Got.
Yeah.
Nunca llegó.
Got. Run.
Uy.
Run.
Run.
Wake.
Walk. Walk.
Walk. Ride.
Road.
Road. Rise.
Rose.
Ah, no.
Rose.
Rose.
Bien, rosa.
Exactly. Rise, rose. Sing.
Sang.
Sang. Come.
Sang.
Come.
Came, give.
Gave.
Gave. Exactly. Okay, no.
New.
New, exactly.
New.
Very good. Easy, right? Blow.
Yeah.
Blow. Oops. Oh, now it already. Let's see. Sorry, guys. Okay, there you go. So I'm gonna send you the link. Okay. Okay, blow.
Blow.
Blue.
Blue.
Drink.
Drink.
Write.
Wrote.
Exactly. Wrote. Wrote. Draw.
Drew.
Drew. Sit.
Sat.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Okay, we have the ones that end with O-U-G-H-T. For example, buy.
Boat.
Bring.
Brown.
Brought. Teach.
Touch.
Stop. Think.
Sold.
Soft. Okay?
Teacher, have a question.
Go ahead.
By and Brian. Son iguales. Brown, brown.
No, no, no. By, but.
Ah, lleva una R. Bone.
Bring, broke.
Broke. Okay.
Okay, and we have used that N in PT. For example, sleep.
Let.
Keep.
Yep.
Kept. Sweep. Swept. Let's check.
No lo voy a borrar todavía.
Hey, now, let's practice the pronunciation, okay? Swim, swam.
Swam.
Get, got.
Get, got.
Run, run.
Run, run.
Wake, walk.
Wake, walk.
Ride, road.
Ride, road.
Rise, rose.
Rise,
rose.
Sing, sang.
Sing, sang.
Come, came.
Come, came.
Game.
Give, gave.
Give, gave.
No, new.
No,
no,
new.
Blow, blue.
Blow,
blow,
blue.
Yes, like the color, blue. Drink,
drink.
Drunk.
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 Drunk. Drunk water. Right.
Right.
Wrote.
Right.
Right. Wrote.
Draw.
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 Drew.
Draw.
Drew.
Sat.
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 Buy, bought.
Buy,
bought. Bring, brought.
Bring, brought.
Teach, taught.
Teach, taught.
Think, thought.
Think,
thought. Yes. Sleep, slept.
Sleep,
slept.
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 Left. Keep, kept.
Keep,
keep, kept.
Kept.
Swim, swept.
Swim, swept.
Yes, thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Okay, now another exercise. This is about irregular verbs. Now let's go for regular verbs. What are the rules of regular verbs? We have some rules for regular verbs. The majority of regular verbs, you have to add ed. For example, listen, listened. Es el mismo verbo, pero solo le agregamos ed al final. Cook, cooked. ¿Qué les parece si hacen este ejercicio ustedes? Allí en su teléfono, ¿será que lo pueden hacer? ¿Si se los mando?
Sí, sí, teacher.
Y lo, hacemos, lo escribimos todos, ¿verdad? Vale. Se los voy a mandar. I'm gonna send it to you right now.
Teacher, y el otro que había mandado temprano, se lo teníamos que enviar. Yo lo hice.
Excelente. Ese me gusta porque tiene la pronunciación.
Sí, tenía pronunciación.
Ajá.
Y eran un montón de, eran muchos verbos.
Nice.
Todos eran irregulares.
Yes.
Sí, eran irregulares.
Uh-huh. For you to practice. Okay. Va, entonces ahí vamos a practicar escribiéndolo, ¿verdad? Cook, cooked. Look, looked. Call, called. Walk, walked. Play, played. Help,
helped.
Open, opened. Watch, watched.
What?
Paint, painted. Jump, jumped. Play again, it's repeated. Played, brushed, like brushed your teeth, followed. Okay. Now, some verbs end in E. So the only thing you have to do is just add the D. Como ya tiene la E, solo agregamos la E. Close, closed. Like, liked. Leave, lived. Share, shared. Use, used. Save, saved. Love, loved. Move, moved. Okay. Now, there are some verbs that end with vowel plus consonant. In this case, we are going to double the consonant and we are going to add ed. Vaya, algunos verbos son de una sílaba y terminan así, una vocal y luego hay una consonante. ¿Qué hacemos? Bueno, doblamos o añadimos, doblamos la última consonante, la duplicamos, thank you, y le agregamos ed. For example, skip, skipped. Stop, stopped, double P. Pin, double N, pinned. Clap, double P, clapped. Hop, hopped. And zip, zipped, zipped. Okay? And there are more like planned, flipped, and others. Now, here we have some verbs that end in Y. Estos terminan en Y. Hay una, en este caso, si ustedes se fijan, no aplica para play. ¿Por qué? ¿Alguien tiene una idea?
Doble. Porque hay una consonante.
Ah, porque hay una vocal antes de la Y, entonces no aplica para played. Ajá. Pero en este caso hay consonante y la Y. Entonces sí, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a quitar, we're going to remove the Y. And we are going to add instead I, ED. Cry, cried. Fry, fried. Try, tried. Dry, dried. Study, studied. Carry, carried. Mary, married.
Married.
Copy, copied. Okay? Copied. Questions so far? Did you finish the exercise?
Yes.
No.
Teacher, ¿por qué este dry no lo pone como que está malo?
Sí, es un error.
Pero puso malo también.
Ese error.
En el otro, porque
yo puse en minúscula. Una letra mal. Porque lo pusieron en minúscula.
Pero todas las hemos puesto así. Sí, es error de la página.
Pongo en mayúscula el drill, inicien con mayúscula y voy a ver que sale bien.
Drive. Sí, es error de la página. Don't worry. Ah, mire, me lo tomó a 10, ¿eh? I got an excellent score. Y este me lo calificó, a ver. Me saqué 10. I got 10.
Me saqué 9.
Pero así vamos aprendiendo, ¿ok? That's the way we learn.
Pero es que me equivoqué en una letra. Y ese dry me lo agarró mal.
Sí, pero es error de...
Tiene dos errores.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very good. So you have the link to practice, okay? Learning English is a lot of practice. Very good. So let's continue with the next, with the other part of the class. Very good. So, vocabulary. For this exercise, first, I would like you to repeat after me the expressions, okay? Number one, pick up the phone.
Pick up the phone.
Understand.
Understand.
Explain.
Complain. Help.
Request information.
Get prices.
Provide one's information.
Assist.
Bye.
Call.
Receive. Mm-hmm. Okay. Receive. Which of these activities does a customer do? Which of these ones does the customer do? Does the customer provide one's information or assist or
help?
Okay, the customer.
Request information.
Get prices. Okay.
Provide one's information.
Okay, let's see. Vaya, vamos a ver. The customer. Complain. Complain. Complain is, for example, what Mr. Cañengues was doing. Yes, teacher. Yeah, we tell you what to do, but you don't do what we ask. Okay, that is complaining. Okay? Cuando usted expresa algo que no le parece.
Okay, su o punto sea, de vista.
O sea, quejarse. Complain. Eso hace el cliente, ¿verdad? Cuando algo no le parece. The client or the customer complains. Okay, what else? The customer.
Bye.
Request information.
Exactly. Provide one's information.
Buy. The customer provide one's information. Exactly. Because when you call the company's representative or the agent tells you, can you please give me your credit card's number or your telephone number or your full name, etc. What else does the customer do?
Help, teacher.
Help.
¿El cliente ayuda o el agente?
Get prices.
Get prices, exactly. When you ask for the prices, you get prices. What else?
Understand.
Request information.
Okay.
Yes, request information.
Puede ser, ambos lo hacen, ¿verdad? Request information.
Yes. Receive.
Call. Exactly. The customer call.
Receive.
And the customer receive information or receive something. Okay, what about the company's representative or agent?
Assist.
Pick up.
Bueno, aquí se nos olvidó algo. Miren, el customer assist. Pick up the phone. Toma el teléfono.
Yes.
A llamar. Okay, the company's representative help. Explica.
Assist,
que también es ayudar. Assist.
Asistir.
Understand.
Understand.
Okay. Bueno, también el customer understand, right?
Explain.
Yeah. Request information.
Reserve.
Receive
the call. Okay. Very good. Excellent. Now, guys, let's practice vocabulary and grammar. You are going to write sentences in past using the previous example, the previous vocabulary. You can see the example here. The vocabulary is pick up the phone. What is the past of pick? The past of pick is picked. It's regular verb. So the secretary picked up the phone to answer the call. Okay? Hey. La secretaria tomó el teléfono, ¿no? Picked up the phone to answer the call. Now, guys, you are going to write sentences in past using this vocabulary. The past of understand is?
Understood.
Understood. The past of explain? Explained. The past of complain.
Complained.
The past of help.
Helped.
The past of request.
Requested.
Get prices.
Got.
Provide.
Provided.
Assist.
Assisted.
Yes. By.
But.
Call.
Called.
Call.
Receive.
Call. Received.
Received.
Received. Okay. So let's please write sentences using this vocabulary and make them in past. And you can write those sentences in the chat. And I'm gonna be here reading your sentences, okay? So let's work on that, guys, please.
Individual, teacher.
Individually. How many students are we have? 17. Okay. 16. Me daban ganas de darles uno a cada uno. Well, yeah. Later, I can ask you.
Understood, teacher.
Yes.
Understood, it is with W-O.
Double O. Yes, you're right.
Teacher.
Yes, Matias?
The customer receives the chain of the product.
Okay. The customer received a change of the product. Okay, nice.
Puede ser en términos de pregunta o una oración o como sea.
Yes, you decide. You are free.
Teacher, the client, request my help.
Explain.
The client requested
my help.
My
help, me ayuda.
My help, okay. Yes, it's correct.
Teacher.
Yes, Matias.
The boss bought the raw material.
Bought. That's bought. Right. Yes.
Bought.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I mute myself because there is a dog barking. I'm sorry for that. You can type your sentences in the chat.
Oh. Yo lo estaba escribiendo en el libro.
Yes, that is good too. Don't worry, it's okay.
Teacher.
Tell me, I listen.
Okay, the verb is in past.
Exactly.
And don't use the auxiliary or another verb in past. Por ejemplo, it was.
No, aquí no.
Okay.
Vaya, fíjense que preferiría que hicieran oraciones afirmativas porque todavía no hemos visto cómo formular las preguntas en pasado. Eso lo vamos a ver el lunes, on Monday. ¿Ok? So let's go little by little, ¿ok? Vamos a ir de poquito a poquito, ¿sí?
Well,
I see very nice examples. The customer complained about the quality of the product. They understood the exercises. Oh, really, Mathlon? Nice. Mathlon bought a car. Fatima got the prices of new products today. I help load the products to the truck. Okay. Marlon says it's just an example, but it will be nice if you buy a car. The teacher explained the English class. Okay. My mother complained in the school with the director. Okay, director in English, director of a school is principal. Director de una escuela se dice principal. School's principal. Okay. I received one packet from the United States. Nice. What did you get?
Sample, teacher, sample.
That's just an example. Yeah. I was very excited. No. Okay. Are you about to finish, guys?
Okay.
Okay, let's go one by one. I requested information to get a promotion. Okay. Okay, what about a sentence using assist?
Teacher, la estructura entonces es subject, verb in the past, and
complement.
Okay.
You are right, Jose Matias. Yes. Aprendizaje por descubrimiento. I love that.
Otra vez.
Yes, of course. Okay, what about the sentence using the verb assist, using the verb get prizes, using the verb provide one's information? Okay, Nancy, my sister wrote a report at her work. Okay. ¿Está bien, Nancy? ¿Qué tal si también utilizamos este vocabulario que tenemos en pantalla? Carlos, the company's representative explained 3 times the information. Okay. It was a hard topic, I guess. Okay, guys, I think the majority have participated in the chat, sending their sentences, okay? Very good, thanks a lot. Now, guys, in the next slide, we have here some questions. Okay, how would you answer to these questions? It says, choose the department where you work in and a friend. Explain to a partner what activities you do there in your department at your work, okay? So what do customers call for at your department? And what was the last call you had about? Bueno, esto lo vamos a hacer así de forma general. ¿Quiénes reciben llamadas? Who receive calls at work? ¿Quiénes de ustedes? Who of you receive calls at work? Okay, Nancy. Only Nancy?
Me too, teacher.
Okay, Mr. Cañengues. Okay, Nancy, what do the customers, okay, Fatima, what do customers call for? What is the reason why they call? What do customers call for? Nancy? Or Fatima?
Okay. They call me when they need to get any information because or maybe they want to remember us that we have any information pending to send to them, because most of the time they request information only by mail because they have to copy many people in the email. So they call me just only when they want to remember us that we have information pending to send, or if they want to receive if they need to get the information that we can provide by phone.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much, Fatima, for your participation. Mr. Cañengues?
In my case, no exactly customer, but coworker, yes. For example, when they have the problem in a report, in either in others, or something, or song for the job or work, I try to help them.
Very nice, thank you. Okay, and the next question is, what was the last call you had about? The last call you had, what was it about?
For example, the last week about the new way the pay.
Oh, the new way of payment.
Yes, la del Chivo wallet.
Bitcoin.
And I. Y yo estaba más perdido que ella.
You que didn't have information.
Yes, yes. But I helped. Pero les ayudé.
But you helped.
I helped.
You helped them. Okay, very good. Thank you guys for your contributions. Now, let's learn about the paso B. Vale, entonces ahorita vamos a olvidarnos un poquito de los irregulares y de los regulares, ¿ok?
Ok.
Nos vamos a olvidar un poquito de ellos. Y vamos a ver the past of B. Ok, here there are some examples of the past of B. We have. ¿Quién le gustaría leer los ejemplos? Who would like to read?
Me, teacher.
Okay, go ahead.
Past of B. ¿Esa verdad?
Yes.
It was a great experience. The agent was very helpful. You were on our page. We were excited about service.
Thank you so much, Mr. Velázquez. So as you can see, in the present, it could be, it is a great experience. But in the past, we changed is for was. It was a great experience. The agent was very helpful. You were on our page. We were excited about service. Here you can see a little chart with subject and the verb be form. Okay.
Sure.
For example, I was, you were, he was, she was, it was, we were, you were, and they were. ¿Por qué? Vaya, por ejemplo, en el presente decimos I am. Entonces, en el pasado vamos a decir I was. En el presente decimos you are. En el pasado.
Were.
You were. En you el presente, he is. En el pasado.
He was.
She is.
He is.
He was.
He was. It is.
It was.
But igual. We are.
We were.
You are.
You were.
They are.
They were.
Así de simple. Dígame, Pierre.
No dije yo, no hablé.
Ah, Amilcar, perdón.
Okay, and the last sentences in part of B. Why the bird is excited when to use where?
Aquí no es un verbo, fíjese, Mr. Cañengues, es un adjetivo.
Ah, ok.
Ajá, okay. Muchos adjetivos son como, parecen ser verbos en pasado, pero son adjetivos. Bueno, por ejemplo, en el primero sería, fue una gran experiencia. Segundo, el agente fue muy...
Amable.
No.
Amable.
Muy amable.
Helpful.
Bien, bien amable. Muy amable.
Útil, servicial.
Muy ayudante.
Bastante amable, bastante servicial.
Poco inútil.
You were on our page. Tú estuviste o estabas en nuestra página. We were excited about service. Estábamos emocionados del servicio. Emocionados, excited.
Entusiasmado.
You were.
Y ahí donde está, en la tablita donde está el soldier y el verb to be, después de we está you. Ese you no es your, o así es you.
¿Se refiere aquí? ¿A esto?
No.
Ajá, no, no. Es we. Es abajo de we were, you were,
you.
No es your.
Ah,
no.
Es que arriba you. You es de tú, ¿verdad? Y ese you de abajo.
De ustedes.
Vaya, es que you aquí es segunda persona singular. Tú o usted. Y aquí abajito es segunda persona plural.
Ustedes.
Ustedes. Ustedes. En plural.
Y hay que llevar la R dicha al final.
No.
Es que ahí estaba confundida yo, que sí, tenía que llevar R, pero ya, o sea que yo puedo referirme a una persona con you, así como puedo referirme a varias personas con you.
Yes.
Sí, es igual.
Teacher, una yes. Consulta, ¿cuándo es que, para ese sí es una buena, ese es, para aclarar algo, cuándo es que se tendría que llevar R al final?
Eso es cuando estamos hablando de los posesivos. Por ejemplo,
posesivo.
Yo digo,
mi teléfono.
Por ejemplo, my cell phone, your cell phone, his cell phone, her cell phone, our cell phones.
Nosotros, nuestros teléfonos.
Their cell phones.
Your es posesivo, es cuando algo es tuyo. Entonces se dice your pencil, your books, your computer, your...
Mm-hmm. Very good. Thank you for your
comments, Mr. Es cuando igual, casi se ocupa igual cuando decimos me.
My.
Igualito.
Okay. Pues okay.
Posesivo.
Oh, sí, es posesivo, ya sé, entonces.
Nice, Domingo. Okay, so okay. Look at this example. Ah, bueno, in this exercise. Tell me how your day was. Oh, my day was really good and busy, but it was good. Tell me how the traffic was. Today the traffic was normal. Tell me how your meals were. My breakfast was light. My lunch was delicious. I ate a burrito. And my dinner was very healthy. I had a salad, tomato, cucumber, onions, papaya, and carrots. Okay, now guys.
Chile verde.
Oh,
¿cómo se
yeah.
Dice chile verde?
I forgot the green pepper.
Green pepper, okay.
Okay, guys. You are going to do this exercise in the rooms. So you're gonna ask your part. First, you should write in your notebook or in your book about you. Okay, how your day was, how the traffic was, and how your meals were. Okay?
Teacher.
And then we share with your partners in the breakup rooms. Yes, Nancy?
Antes de irnos a los breakup rooms, no sé si va a pasar la lista.
Exactamente, eso les iba a decir ahorita. Ahorita les voy a...
Ya pasó una hora. ¡Qué rápido el tiempo! No he sentido la hora.
I'm going to take the attendance. Please stay present here. Hey, thank you for the reminder, Nancy. Ok, voy a empezar de abajo para arriba. Jasmine, Melanie Lemus.
Present, teacher.
William Eduardo Pérez.
Present.
Daniel González. Víctor Salazar.
Present, teacher.
Sandra Velázquez.
Present, teacher. No me mencioné. O no escuché.
Es que hoy estoy al revés. Salvador Escobar.
Sorry.
Salvador. I saw him.
Hi,
where? Ah, it's there. Okay. No jueguen con mis sentimientos. A veces pienso que están o no están. Okay, Salvador. Rocío Martínez. Nancy no, Rodríguez. Maideli Judith. Mauricio Alexander. Marlon Cardona.
Present.
Marco David.
Present, teacher.
José Matías.
I'm
He's
here.
Not here. Fátima. He's never present. In class. Present. Amir Carcañé. Perdón. Sorry. Fátima, okay. Domingo.
Present, teacher.
Cristina.
Present.
Carlos.
Present.
Amílcar.
Present.
Alfredo.
Present.
Alba.
Here.
¿Estará Alba?
Here.
No está Alba. Alba isn't here.
Okay.
No, right? Here. She's not. Okay. Thank you. And now, what are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Write about the questions and share my answer.
Okay, yes. First, you finish your sentences about your day, traffic, and your meals. Tres cosas, three things. Ahí estaba en la presentación. Ahí está en la presentación. Así como el ejemplo, ustedes van a responder para usar was and where.
What is meals, teacher? I don't forget.
Meals, breakfast, lunch, dinner. Three meals a day. Okay?
Thanks.
You're welcome. And then you ask and answer in the rooms, in the groups. You practice. ¿Qué le van a decir a su compañero? Por ejemplo, imagínese que está trabajando con Marlon. Entonces le va a decir, Marlon, tell me about how your day was today. And then Domingo, tell me about how was the traffic. Mauricio, tell me how your meals were. ¿Ok? Y ahí usted va a decir la respuesta. You give the answer. Go ahead.
Hola, Mauricio. Este, ¿me podría mandar la captura? Acabo de entrar y no sé qué es lo que va a hacer.
¿Quién va? Ahorita se la envío. ¿Qué va? La voy a poner en el grupo de WhatsApp. Teacher, que yo también ando algo perdido, ¿verdad? Y que son oraciones que vamos a hacer.
Yo lo que alcancé a entender que era practice.
Teacher, no oímos, no escuchamos.
I'm so sorry. Okay, can you see my screen?
Okay.
¿Pueden ver la pantalla?
Yes.
Vale, aquí les he puesto mi ejemplo, pero ustedes van a hacer sobre ustedes. Por ejemplo, van a decir, tell me how your day was. ¿Cómo, dígame cómo estuvo su día? Entonces va a decir, aquí va a escribir usted, my day was, y ahí va a poner lo que usted piensa, ¿verdad? De cómo estuvo su día. It was fantastic, terrible, busy, tiring. Tell me how the traffic was. Va a decir, dígame cómo estuvo el tráfico. Y ahí va a decir usted cómo estuvo el tráfico. The traffic was normal, was heavy, was difficult, was slow. Tell me how your meals were. ¿Cómo estuvieron sus comidas? Iba a decir, my breakfast was light. Este es mi ejemplo. My lunch was delicious and great. And my dinner was very healthy. Entonces, ustedes allí lo completan. ¿Ok?
Ah, ok, ok.
Y luego usted le va a decir a William, William, tell me how your day was. Y William le va a contestar. De ahí, otra vez, vea, tell me how the traffic was. Y William le va a contestar. O Sandrita, porque ahí está también. Tell me how your meals were. Y ya usted va a decir, su compañero va a responderle, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad?
¿Hoy sí? Okay. Sí, hoy sí.
¿Le pueden tomar captura o lo mandan? Ok.
William, tell me how your day was.
Perdón, no entendí.
La primera. Tell me how your day was. ¿Cómo estuvo?
My day was terrible.
Terrible.
I work in a factory, like an assistant of merchandise assistant.
Factory.
Garment.
Factory what?
They produce garments. Jacket. Winter jacket.
Manufacture?
Mm-hmm.
Manufacture. Oh, okay.
Yes.
The, you work in the human resource?
No, I work in the merchandise. In the merchandise department, we receive the orders from clients, and we buy the materials to produce the garments.
Do you have an office?
Yes, we are in the same office. The team, the merchandise team, are in the same office.
Very nice.
Yeah. Very like nice. A call center. Okay. Yeah, but sometimes yeah. we are relaxed, but some days are very stressful. There are many issues yeah. that we have to
yes.
to resolve.
My work usually is relaxed too, but this.
Hello, Nancy.
Hi, teacher.
Can you tell me how your day was?
No le comprendí, teacher.
How was your day? Good, easy, difficult, terrible, great. How was your day?
Cool.
It was good.
Difficult.
Oh, it was difficult. Why?
Yeah.
I'm sorry to hear that. Okay, tell me, how was the traffic?
El tráfico.
Yes.
Es lo único que estaba excelente.
The traffic was.
The traffic was excellent.
Okay, what about your meals? How were your meals today? ¿Cómo estuvieron sus comidas?
Very good.
Okay, they were very good. They were very good.
They were very good.
Were they healthy? Saludables, they were healthy?
Yes, teacher.
Good for you. Good for you. Let's go back. Guys, how was your day?
More tired.
Very tiring. Your day was tiring. Okay.
More tired of normal.
Oh. Okay, was more tiring than normal. What about the traffic? How was the traffic today?
Normal.
It was normal. Yeah, I was surprised to see that. Yeah. It was normal.
Mm-hmm. And other day was very, very heavy.
Exactly. And slow, but today was easy. It was normal. What about your meals? Who would like to tell me about the meals you had today? How were your meals?
The morning, my breakfast, it's a good a coffee with the bread. My lunch, I am very hungry because I was take at 1:35 minutes.
So you were very hungry.
Yeah. And my dinner, 7 o'clock, but it's delicious.
It was delicious.
It was delicious.
Yeah. It was delicious. Okay, thank you so much.
Right.
Okay, so let's continue practicing about a use of was and where, okay? So right here in the presentation, I have more exercises. Wait a moment. Okay, so right here, look at these examples or these exercises. You have to complete with was or where, okay? Let's do it together. I have this problem with the mouse. Oh. Se me pierde el mouse, niños. Okay, but you can see, right? You can see the exercise. You have to choose if it's present or if it's past. Am, is, are, or was, and where. Okay? Let's do it together. Vale, les voy a ir preguntando.
Okay, okay.
Let's see, let's start with Fátima. Number one, read and complete at the same time.
Okay, last year he was 22, so he is 23 now.
Excellent. Okay, number two, Mr. Cañangas.
Today the weather's is dying. But yesterday it was very cold.
Very good. Okay, number three, Marlon.
Okay, teacher. I was hungry. Can I have something to eat?
Mm-hmm. Are you sure?
I am hungry.
It's present.
It's present. Present.
I'm
am
sorry. I'm hungry.
I'm hungry.
Can I have something to eat? Okay, very good. Number four, Domingo.
I feel fine this morning. Book, I am very dry last night. I was very tired last night.
Excellent. Yes, but I was very tired last night. Okay, number five. It's a question. Okay. Marco David.
Okay, is where where was you at 11 o'clock last Friday morning?
No.
What do you use with you? Was or where?
Here, say where.
Where?
11 o'clock last Friday morning.
Exactly. It's the same pronunciation. Where were you? Ajá, where? ¿Dónde estabas tú? A las 11 en punto. El viernes pasado en la mañana. Uh-huh.
Only has an age.
Okay, number six. Who's missing? Matías?
Okay. Don't buy those shoes. They were very expensive.
It's in the present. Don't buy those shoes.
Excuse me, they are.
They are very expensive. No compres esos zapatos, están bien caros. Okay. Number seven. Volunteer, Nancy? Or someone? Cristina? ¿Cuál teacher?
Yes.
Okay.
¿Cuál va, teacher?
Seven.
I like you need jacket.
It's a question.
No sé si what or where.
Was. Uh-huh. With was. It, we use. Uh-huh. Was it expensive? Very good, Nancy. I like your new jacket. Was it expensive? Yes, it was very expensive. I bought it in the shopping center.
What is expensive is...
It costs you a lot of money. Exactly.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Number eight, Cristina.
Yes, this time last year I was Paris.
Great. Alfredo, number nine.
Where is the children? I don't know. They was in the garden 10 minutes ago.
Mm-hmm. With they what were, do we use?
Where are
they were?
Exactly. And the they question?
Where is the children?
Children?
Ah, where are the children?
Where are the children? I don't know. They were in the garden 10 minutes ago. Okay. Number 10.
Me.
Okay. Rocío.
No, Jasmine.
Ah, Jasmine, sorry.
Hello, everybody. I am sorry. I were late.
¿Cuál usamos con I?
I am sorry. I were late.
I was.
Pero en este caso es presente. Hello, everybody. I'm sorry. I am late. Porque... pues esta tarde, ¿vea? In the present.
Entonces, en ambas es I am.
I am sorry, sorry, I am late.
I am late.
Ah,
¿quién me falta? ¿Number 11?
Me, teacher.
Okay, go ahead.
Where are you born? I was born in India.
In India. Ok, number 11. ¿Dónde nació? Se dice where were, in the past. Where were you born? Okay. I was born in India. Ok, number 12. Mauricio?
We were married when I am 18 and Roger is 20.
It's in the past.
Ah, okay. Roger was 20. Was 20.
The whole sentence is in the past.
I was 18 and Roya is 20.
We were married when I was 18 and Roya was 20. Good.
Was.
Veo que todavía tenemos aquí en general, ¿verdad? Algunas confusiones cuando es con was y cuando es where. Pero acuérdense, singular, was.
Was.
Plural,
where.
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 With you, usamos where. ¿Ok? Bye. Now, when we talk about the past tense, we use some time expressions, past time expressions. For example, last night. Repeat after me. Last night.
Last night.
Last week.
Last weekend.
Last month. Last year.
Last Monday.
Ajá, ¿qué significa anoche, la semana pasada, el fin de semana pasado, el mes pasado, el lunes pasado? Now, ago means hace. For example, 10 minutes ago, hace 10 minutos. Ajá. Repeat after me. 10 minutes ago.
10 minutes ago.
An hour ago. 3 days ago.
2 days ago.
A week ago.
A month ago.
A year ago. Okay. Yesterday morning. Yesterday afternoon. Yesterday evening. The day before yesterday. Sería ayer en la mañana. Ayer en la tarde, ayer en la noche, tarde-noche, el día antes de ayer, que ¿cómo antier. Decimos aquí?
Antier.
Ajá. Antier. Yesterday night.
Ahí en la
noche.
¿Y cómo se dice then de hoy, teacher?
Moment ago.
How do you say then de hoy?
A moment ago. Hace un momento, right? Then de hoy. A moment ago.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome, Amilcar.
Esas son expresiones del idioma.
Del idioma.
Si no está, lo inventamos.
Ok.
Somos autodidactas.
Yeah. Ok, yeah, that's right. Good. Ok, guys, now let's learn about the past tense of other verbs. Vaya, ahora. Nos vamos a olvidar, vamos a dejar el was y el where a un ladito, ahí descansando, ¿verdad? Porque ya tiene sueño. Y ahora vamos a despertar al simple past of other verbs. Ahora sí, con otros verbos, ¿verdad? We have some examples here. Let's see. Let me ask. Vamos a ver quiénes están por ahí. Cristina?
Mimi?
Okay, Jasmine. Can you read the sentences, please?
Simple past. I gave my account information. He called it yesterday at night. The program worked well. The bowl that produced last week. Sigo.
No, that's okay. Thank you. Entonces, como ven, como decía Matías, ¿verdad? Sujeto, verbo en pasado y complemento.
Complemento.
I gave my account information. He called yesterday at night. Y aquí tenemos una expresión del tiempo, past time expression. The program worked well. And they bought that product last week.
No es worked, sino worked.
Worked. Ajá, you got a point there, Amilcar. en las próximas clases, in the next classes, when you're going to learn pronunciation rules about the regular verbs. Vamos a ver la pronunciación, pero hoy creo que es suficiente con que hemos visto el spelling, ¿ok?
Teacher, pero vamos a ver la prácticamente en una conversación, todo eso, casi que no mucho, ¿verdad, teacher? Porque no va a estar pronunciándolo bien, si yo he visto que ellos se lo tragan todas las ED, la E, la, todo eso. Cuando están hablando, yo solo no, ahí no, yo no he escuchado que digan worst en una oración.
Como no,
solo
no
tragado lo hacen.
Sí lo dicen.
Tienes que educar el oído.
De una forma rápida.
Ajá, entonces nosotros estamos aprendiendo ellos de un solo, ¿van?
Sí, he oído que de un solo se lo pasan tragando todo.
Después
el,
lo van a hacer ustedes, así. Ya nacieron con ese
idioma.
Calmado, Matías, luego lo vas a hacer.
Okay, guys, now tell me three things you did today. For example, what did you do today at work? In my case, today I graded some exams, I made some reports, and I prepared a PowerPoint presentation for the class. So, what about you? Write, please, in your notebook, three things you did today. It could be at work or at home. If you didn't go to work today, you can tell me about things you did. Activities that you did today.
Dry draw, teacher.
Exactly.
Or driver.
No, draw.
Teacher, forgot es olvidé.
Yes, forgot.
Forgot.
Teacher, tres oraciones. ¿De qué?
En pasado.
En pasado.
Sí, about what you did today.
Teacher.
¿Qué hizo hoy? Yes, mami.
Teacher. When I say hice, did or make?
Hice.
Yes.
Make, pero el pasado es más.
Depende qué. Si hizo ejercicio, did exercise.
Ah, okay. Y en work, activities of work.
Depende. It depends.
Okay, make.
Yes,
make.
Make is like create. Cuando usted usa make es para crear como algo que usted creó. Como por ejemplo, I made a cake. I made some pupusas.
I make an inventory.
Okay. You made an inventory report. Pero si usted es una acción, si es una acción, va a usar do. Did. Si es una acción, por ejemplo, I did my homework. Hice mi tarea. I did my homework. I did exercise. I did the laundry. Hice la lavandería. I did the laundry.
Y the expression I make the supermarket is incorrect.
It's incorrect.
Porque muchos dicen hice las compras.
I did no es the esto. Shopping.
Or I went.
I went shopping or I did the shopping.
I went.
Ajá, fui a de compras o hice las compras. I did the grocery shopping.
Okay, grocery. Thank you.
Teacher.
Teacher.
Le digo la oración o usted nos va a preguntar después.
Gonna ver. What time is it? 9:42. De todos modos no va a haber tiempo para hacer el role play, so I'm gonna send you to breakout rooms for you to practice, okay?
Okay.
No vamos a tener tiempo para hacer the role play anyways. Pero creo que todo lo que hemos visto hoy ha estado muy bien, ¿verdad? El contenido. Muy importante.
Muy intenso.
Exactly. A lot of things. I know. Y ya me querían salir con las preguntas y el negativo. No, 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 no. Tomorrow, okay. Negative one, tomorrow. In questions in another class. Go ahead, guys.
Vamos a sala.
Yes. Y ahí se van a preguntar.
Okay.
The inspection.
You made some inspection.
You made the inspection.
You made inspection.
No, no, no. O sea, vos me estás diciendo yo hice una inspección. Entonces yo estoy confirmándote. You made the inspection.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
He made this picture. What did you do? Other?
Other, what did you do? Quise hoy.
Uh-huh. You made an inspection.
Mm-hmm.
And next activity?
Activity is what? Connection, life.
You made a connection light?
You made I made a connection light.
I made some light connections.
I made some light connection.
Light connections.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's it.
Okay. You make.
Make.
May, como made in China, made in El Salvador.
Made, made, ajá, exactly.
Made.
I made them.
I made that?
The meditar, the exam.
The midterm.
The mid, ya nos toca, no. ¿Verdad, teacher?
Sí, ya la tenía. Ahora en la mañana me dio el reporte.
I don't made.
No, ahí no, lo, no tienen que usar make, sino do.
I don't. I do it. No, I don't.
I didn't do it.
I didn't do it.
I didn't do it. You can still do it. Do it tonight. Do it after the class.
Yes.
Okay.
In my case.
Pero para decir que me preparé una taza de café, sí es made.
I made a cup of coffee, yes.
Es que yo sí, la
sí, porque ustedes no crearon el examen. Lo hicieron, lo tomaron, pero no lo crearon. No hicieron las preguntas.
Entonces, sí. Teacher, y tengo una duda. Yo ya lo hice ahí, pero no entiendo. Bueno, quizás sería de preguntarle después, o no sé, ¿cómo es que evalúan? Porque yo he hecho todas las tareas. Y ahí me sale que tengo 80%, entonces no entiendo.
¿En qué tiene 80%?
Ahí con el reporte que sale de las notas.
Podría, it could, o ¿cómo sería? It will, podría ser, bueno, podría ser que hay una tarea inconclusa. A mí me ha pasado algunas veces. Que tengo sí. Un bajo average y luego voy a ver y me falta completar una tarea.
Pero yo todas las he hecho.
¿Y todas me han salido buenas?
Una me salió una mala. Ah. Y en las otras me han salido buenas. Pero no entiendo cómo.
Puede ser que esa y y como tienes que completarlo todo. ¿Hasta dónde? ¿Hasta dónde?
Yo he estado, ahorita le he hecho hasta la 8. Creo que la clase 8 he hecho.
Ah, pues por eso. Sí. Tiene que ser la 9, la 10 y el midterm.
No, teacher, pero cuando revisé, había hecho todas las clases hasta la 8 fue el último día que hice.
Lo que sucede es que le cuenta 10%. No lo había terminado, ¿verdad?
Ajá, cada clase le cuenta un 10%. Y como le faltaba la 9 y la 10, le falta ese 20%.
Aunque la 9 y la 10 todavía no lo hubiera dado.
Exacto.
Falta que se complete, así que iba a un 80%.
Entonces yo había hecho hasta la clase 8, porque hasta la clase 8 habíamos visto.
Exacto. Entonces,
la 9 y la 10 no la había hecho, pero bueno. Ah, pues.
Por o eso, sea por que eso ayer no se la tenía.
Y de ahí hice el examen también.
Ah, hey, súper bien. Yo no lo he hecho.
Yo lo hice hoy en la tarde.
Bueno,
háganlo. Yes. Okay, in my... Yes. I draw at work. I make and report inventory. I went to grocery shopping. I worked at house and I repaired some at home.
Hello, Alberto. Are you alone or were you practicing with your classmates, Walter and William?
I'm alone, teacher.
I'm so sorry. What did you do today?
Today, I run for to find solution for repair machine.
You run.
Run. I run.
How do you spell it?
R-U-N-N-E-D.
No.
No.
Okay. The past of run is ran.
Run.
Okay, I ran.
No sé qué quería decir. I ran to look for a solution to repair some machines.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Wow. That's very, you know, important at work. What else
I talked with my manager.
You talked to your manager?
For help. Yes, for help. Yes.
You asked for help.
Yes. I am. It was very busy this day.
It was a busy day. Yeah, I can imagine. Okay, thank you so much, Carlos. I think it's time to go back.
Okay.
But you had the opportunity to share. That's good. Wow, guys, the time flew away so fast, this class. So, do I have a volunteer to tell the class what you did today?
Yes, teacher, me.
Okay, Mr. Cañengues, go ahead, we'll listen.
Okay, I draw at work. I make an inventory report. I went the grocery shopping. I work at house. It is equal. I repair some at home.
Excellent. Congratulations, Mr. Cañengues.
Thank you.
Good job. Okay, any other person would like to share with the class and receive applauses?
Me.
Guys, this is your moment for you to shine like a star.
Me.
Okay, Matias Lemus.
Okay.
Cristina was
my day.
Okay, yes, Matias.
In my day. In the morning, I drink coffee with bread.
Yes.
It's very delicious. Okay. I cut 70 package of paper. And I print 30 package paper and finish of my work. I drive up home.
I wrote you rode your motorcycle to home. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Applauses for Matias. Thank you so much. Okay, guys, very good. Now, you only have 3 minutes. COVID. I'm so sorry, Mr. Just kidding. Just a joke. Okay? Just a joke. Okay, now, guys, let's make like a summary of the simple past regular verbs. as I explained to you, past tense regular verbs. Remember, what are the rules? ¿Quién me explica la primera regla? O una de las reglas.
Por lo menos. Por lo menos una de tiene que llevar.
Yo.
Vaya.
La segunda regla es una ed.
¿Yasmín?
Que el verbo base se le agrega se add ed.
Ed. Ajá. You add ed.
Add ed.
Add ed. D. Cuando termina en e se le agrega una d. Cuando termina y y a la par está una consonante, se le agrega, se le quita la y y se le pone ied.
Cuando termina
en
vocal
consonante, se le duplica la consonante y se le agrega ed.
What about this one? Stop. One syllable verb. Es un verbo corto de una sílaba, pero va y una vocal y una consonante. Entonces, I double the last consonant and I add ed.
Yes.
Good job. Miren, ya no tuvimos tiempo para hacer esa tarea, pero ustedes la tienen allí y la pueden hacer y me mandan pictures. Okay? You send me a picture that you completed. Okay. Please.
Teacher, fíjese que de la clase número 9, de la que eran de solo las contestar en la tarea en el sistema.
Plataforma.
En la plataforma, perdón. Allí las tres me salieron malas, solo dos me salieron buenas. Las primeras tres me salieron malas, no sé por qué.
Bueno, cuando le suceda así, mándenme captura y escríbame para ayudarle en el momento a solucionar.
O nos ayudamos ahí.
También, ajá, lo puede hacer en el grupo ahí. Los chicos son bien,
sí, porque
bien
yo,
amables.
Todas, are very todas me salieron buenas.
Teacher.
Yes.
Cuando yo ingresé a la clase, usted estaba con la lista de aquellos verbos que usted les iba poniendo el equivalente. Del pasado. Entonces yo le pedí si podía compartir eso y al final lo compartió.
Yes, in the WhatsApp group.
Son los enlaces que aparecen allí.
Exactly.
Okay, very thank you.
You're welcome.
You are a nice woman.
Thank you. Okay, guys, tell me 10 regular verbs. Vaya, uno, díganme así uno cada uno. Nancy. Regular.
Regular. O irregular. Regular.
Think.
Learn. No, ese es irregular. Tiene que ser regular. Regular, diet. Que termina en ed. It ends.
Love.
Teacher, play it.
Played.
Played.
Paid.
Opened.
Like.
Opened.
Open.
Closed. Finished. We finished the class. Worked.
Closed.
Closed.
Code. Code.
Called.
Arrived.
Very good. Okay, tell me irregular verbs. Go.
Wrong.
Go. Went.
Get.
Went.
Toe. Did.
Understand.
Understood.
Eat.
Eight.
Have. Had. Okay.
Ten.
Tell me one sentence using was. The class was.
I was. It.
Finished. The class was. Beautiful.
The class very well. Very delicious.
The class starts at 8 o'clock.
The class started at 8 o'clock. Okay, that was using a past tense. Now, one sentence using were. The students were very attentive today and very participative.
Walker where?
Yes.
Okay, guys. I forgot. I have to take the attendance. I'm so sorry, guys. I forgot. Oh, just give me one more minute.
Bye, okay? Teacher.
Alba, Alfredo.
Present.
Amilka.
Present.
Carlos Gualberto.
Present.
Cristina Roxana.
Present.
Domingo.
Present.
Fátima.
Present.
Matías. Marco.
Present.
Marlon.
Present.
Mauricio.
Present.
Maydelee. Nancy.
Present, teacher.
Rocío. Salvador.
Present.
Sandra.
Present in the chat.
Víctor.
Present.
Walter Daniel. William. And Jasmine Melanie. Good night, people. Present. Today is Mauricio's turn to stay.
Good night.
A beautiful night, people.
Good night, people. Have a nice weekend. Good
night, teacher.
Good night.
Good night.
Awesome.
Víctor, ¿tiene algo que decirme? No, good night. Sweet dreams. Hello, Mauricio. How are you?
Hello, teacher. Very well.
Okay.
Very well. Un poco cansado.
I'm sorry?
With sleep.
Ah, you are sleepy. You are tired. You want to go to bed right now.
Tengo unas dudas, teacher.
Okay.
Vaya, yo entendí el was, where es el pasado del verbo to be, ¿verdad?
Exactly.
Entonces, es que me confundí en la oración porque, vaya, yo vi que el verbo estaba en pasado, entonces yo ahí entendí que era was o where, ¿verdad? Dependiendo el sujeto, ¿verdad? Porque el verbo estaba en pasado. Sí, en pasado simple, regular, perdón. Era un verbo regular porque llevaba ed.
Uh-huh.
Entonces allí yo entendí que era was o where. Pero ya en el complemento de la oración no entendí por qué me quedó was. Era por el contexto de la oración. Fue la última que me tocó a mi teacher del ejemplo donde...
El ejercicio.
Sí.
Ve, déjeme ver, lo voy a mostrar. La número 12.
Sí. We. Ahí entendí que sí era we were, ¿verdad? Porque el verbo está en pasado, ¿verdad?
Ah, Marriott. Ese Marriott no es un verbo, es un adjetivo.
Ah, ya. Yeah.
Ajá, que es estar casado.
Uh-huh. Pero entonces después del we no iría el were.
¿Cómo no? We were married. O sea, nosotros estábamos casados o nos casamos.
Ah, ya. Yeah. Ajá. When I...
Was, I, cuando yo tenía 18 y Roger tenía 20.
Ah, que es por el contexto, ¿verdad? Que...
Sí, es que fíjese que eso pasa. Eso también lo preguntó alguien más en la clase. Con el adjetivo excited. Hay adjetivos que terminan con ed y entonces parecieran que son verbos en pasado, pero en realidad son adjetivos. Y con el verbo to be, was and were, usamos con el verbo to be en general, ¿verdad? Presente, pasado, futuro, lo usamos siempre para emociones, sentimientos, adjetivos que describen eso, ¿verdad? O descripciones, características, la edad, marital status.
Ah, ok.
Professions, occupations, nationalities. Para eso ocupamos el verbo to be, para decir eso, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. Y quiero ver otra duda que tenía era, con eso del how many y el how much, que por qué el dinero y el tiempo es un countable. ¿Por qué? Porque va, el dinero se puede contar, ¿verdad? Pero ¿por qué se dice que es un countable?
O sea, la palabra dinero, ¿usted dice dinero o no dice dineros?
Uh-huh.
Entonces la palabra money es en general. Y usted no dice give me three monies o give me five monies, ¿verdad que no?
Ah, ya. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Y con el tiempo igual, usted no dice tiempos. Yo tengo un montón de tiempos.
Ah, ya. Yeah.
Ajá, tres tiempos, cinco tiempos. Bueno, sí lo dice si está hablando de veces, cuando el significado es veces. How many times? Pero si estamos hablando del tiempo, del tiempo.
O sea, de que el tiempo sí puede ser countable.
No, el tiempo siempre también es, o sea, sí contamos minutos, segundos, horas, días, meses, años, pero el tiempo general, o sea, time, es no contable.
Ah, ok. ¿Verdad? Otra vez. Has to, ¿verdad? Que es para el he, she, it y I, ¿verdad?
No, I es have. I have to.
Ah, have to es.
Mm-hmm.
O sea, que has to solo sería he, she, it.
Exactly. Very good. Yeah.
Ya.
That's correct.
Ajá. La otra es con lo de esto del this, el this, el that y el does.
Those.
Igual ahí el contexto de la cómo está estructurada la oración me va a decir cuál es el que se va a utilizar, ¿verdad?
Sí, si es singular y está cerca, this.
Singular.
Si es singular, es plural y está cerca, this. Si es una cosa, o sea, singular y está lejos, that, eso. Y si son plurales, those, esos o esas.
Uh-huh. This, that es singular.
Ajá.
Cerca.
No, this es cerca, that es lejos. This es esto, ¿ve? This cell phone. Aquí lo tengo en my hands. It's in my hands. This cell phone is mine. This cell phone is expensive. Por ejemplo. That chair is... that chair is yours. Por ejemplo, esa silla es suya. That chair is yours. That wall is blue. Esa pared es azul. That wall is blue.
Ah, ok.
Esa. Porque no está aquí cerca. Está allí.
¿Y el uso del going to?
Tiene que usarlo con el verbo to be. I am going to. Y luego va un verbo. Es en su base form. I am going to work tomorrow. You are going to have breakfast at work. He is going to travel to Spain next year. she is going to organize a party for her sister. It is going to rain today. We are going preguntar. To finish the class.
Perdón. Para preguntar con...
Are you going to work tomorrow? Is she going to organize a party for her sister?
Primero el verbo to be, después el sujeto. Ah, ok.
Después going to.
Complemento.
Yeah. Muy bien.
Ah, verbo y complemento.
Yes.
Ah, ya, es para preguntarle. Negativo solo es going to not, ¿verdad?
I am not going to. He is not
going antes to. Del going to.
Ajá, we are not. Inmediatamente después del verbo to be.
Ah, ok, ok. Y quiero ver, con las reglas, es que entré un poco tarde, como siempre. Entonces, solo logré entender esa de cuando lleva la Y al final, por ejemplo, play, ¿verdad? Se le quita la Y y se le agrega ED, ¿verdad?
Justamente esa no aplica la regla.
Ah, no aplica.
No, porque tenemos una vocal antes de la Y. Ajá, ajá. Cuando hay una vocal antes de la Y, no, es como otro verbo, solo le agrega ED. Play you.
¿Y, pero y sí, pay?
Por ejemplo, ¿perdón?
Por ejemplo, el verbo pay.
Pagar. Pagar.
¿Sí?
Pay.
No, igual.
Es irregular.
Ah, es irregular, pay.
Ajá.
Ah.
Igual say también es irregular.
Vaya, entonces, ¿cómo es la regla? Cuando vaya. Termina en griega, pero no tiene vocal antes.
Solo por ejemplo, se cry. Cry. Cry.
Ajá.
Entonces ahí sí, cried. Le quita la Y y le pone IED. Fry. Try. Uh-huh. En esa sí aplica. Cried, tried, fried.
Okay. Y verdad es que para saber si el, por ejemplo, yo estaba seguro que pay era regular para saber cuando no es un no hay alguna regla para saber que el verbo no es regular y que cambia su forma totalmente.
No hay una regla.
Ah, ok. Ahí
hay que sí aprenderse.
Hay que aprenderse el listado, ¿verdad? Ah, ok.
Y de ahí, vaya, para la mayoría de los verbos que son regulares, solo le agregamos ed.
Uh-huh.
Para la
eso
mayoría.
Es simple, ¿verdad?
¿Perdón?
Pasado simple.
Sí, pasado simple. Por ejemplo, uh-huh. Look. Looked, visit, visited, need, needed, want, wanted. Ahora, si el verbo termina en E, como por ejemplo like, solo le agrega la D, liked, porque ya la lleva, ¿verdad? O save, saved.
Ajá. Ah, ya. Y creo con lo del cool. Bueno, con lo del cool. Cool es para pedir cosas amablemente, ¿verdad?
Sí, Ken cool.
Es como para, como Ken es un poco informal, entendí yo. Para pedir las cosas un poco informal, ¿verdad?
Correcto. Could you repeat, ya. Please? Good. No pronuncia la L, solo la D. Cool.
Ah, ya. Y siempre se le agrega el please, teacher, cuando lleva cool.
No necesariamente, pero yo ya la tengo ahí bien internalizado, el please.
Ah,
okay. Yo siempre le pongo el please, pero no es necesario, porque como ya cool, ya es polite.
Ya es algo como formal.
Pero sí lo puede decir también.
Uh-huh. ¿Con qué? ¿Con quién se puede decir también?
Sí, Can you repeat, please? Ajá, ya suena más.
Ah, ok. Solo eso, quizás, teacher.
Pero mire, resolvió varias dudas y lo felicito por eso.
Ah, gracias. Gracias a usted, teacher.
Ya sabe, Mauricio. Ahí estamos a la orden, cualquier cosa.
Ah, ok, teacher. Ok.
Descanse, ya que tiene mucho sueño. Yo también.
Voy a trabajar mañana.
Sí, hay que levantarse temprano. Good night.
Good night, teacher.